Mr. Magu, as EFCC chairman, when the Senate first and foremost said they got a security report from the Department of State Security, and apparently the executive also got a different security report. Now, his name is likely to be reconsidered by the Senate. Do you believe corruption war is on course, or corruption itself is fighting back?
Thank you, Magu, for having me. I want to say categorically that if Mr. President has indeed resubmitted the name of Mr. Ibrahim Magu to be confirmed as substantive chairman of EFCC, I think that is a heartwarming news, and I endorse it. Recall that the first time the president sent the name of Magu was around June last year, and the Senate went on vacation, a very long vacation. When they resumed, they considered a lot of communication from the president on appointments, confirmation of judges, and so on and so forth, and to take action on the letter on Magu. I was forced to write to the Senate president on the 1st of November 2016. Drawing his attention to the letter that has been pending and asking why they had not deemed it fit to consider him. And I suggested to the Senate President that you have to take a decision one way or the other. Bring Mr. Magu to plenary. Let him be screened, confirmed, or rejected. But you cannot, suomoto, on your own, refuse to bring the letter for confirmation. And I also recall I pointed out my efforts in that regard to be not of any interest, just as I also fought his own case when he was brought before the CCT. I want to say clearly that for the controversy that has been generated, it seems to me there is something good in Magu that most people didn't want to see, or most people didn't want him to do his job. What are the allegations in the letter? First of all, the issue of accommodation came up, where they said accommodation was rented for about 20 million, making 40 million. I investigated myself since after the Senate decision that it is not true. That accommodation was the handwork of the FCDA, and the accommodation is about 14 million for 2 years. That will give you 28 million. I have also tried to look at the other reasons in the so-called report. I decided on my own to find out whether I was fighting a loose battle. I came to the conclusion that all these allegations were baseless, unfounded, and it was like corruption fighting back. I decided on my own to even text test before you brought this information now that his name has been sent. I want to make it clear that the fight against corruption is not personal. When the president of the Senate was brought before the CCT, I took a position. It was widely publicized. I said Code of Conduct Bureau ought to have called him because the issue in question was not declaring a particular property. Nobody accused him of stealing. If that is the case, if I have my way, I would say Attorney General file a nolle on the Senate president's case because we know the family, we know that they are wealthy, and we are aware that he has inherited a lot. So to fight this corruption or to look at the nomination of somebody as a personal thing is something that we must not accept. The Senate must look at this nomination, which the president has now made from the information available now. If Mr. President has done otherwise, I would have come to the conclusion that Mr. President has on his own ceded his powers out to another body. The president and commander-in-chief of Nigeria is the chief executive officer of the state federation. That is his first definition under the constitution. Nobody can decide for him who will do a particular job. And these are the discretionary powers given to him by the constitution.
The status of Mr. Magu confirmation as the EFCC chairman. There is, in fact, a case in court that was taken to court by an activist and a lawyer, Ebunwade Gburuwa. That case had been adjourned in a Lagos court today. But when we wonder, on one side, a lot of war Mr. Magu is fighting, apart from the one from his own office, there are wars against him. But in this sense, there was a report from the DSS, which we understand that there are two conflicting reports. The president said he was going to investigate, one, the case against the SGF, and the case against Mr. Magu. If Mr. Magu's name resurfaces from the president's office, does it mean that Mr. Magu's plate has been cleaned, or he has a clean slate now?
Exactly. There are two reports. In course of my investigation, I also saw two reports. One purportedly indicting Magu, the other one clearing him, signed by the same person for and on behalf of the DG, SSS, on the same day. Let me assume that the two letters emanated from there. They cancel each other. And President was not in error in finding out of his investigation that there must have been some mix-up somewhere, which is within his government, which is within his government. What is happening to Magu is an internal matter, which, of course, has to do with his fight against corruption. I am satisfied with my investigation that there is nothing incriminating or indicting Magu in this respect. You talk about court case. How many of my learned friends, or those writing in the papers and social media, calling for the removal of Magu, have taken the pain I took to investigate the position of the Senate? None of them has done so. As I'm talking to you, if I knew that you raised this issue when you called me this afternoon, I would have come with documents to show you the outcome of my investigation. We should not vilify, destroy somebody because we do not want him.
All right.
The fight against corruption.
Mr. Chibuwaya, we will take a moment. It's a very good point for us to go on a short break. But when we return, more on some of these critical issues and some other political issues, we hope that the Senate spokesperson will be able to join us via telephone on the program. Join us again.